Hey guys, John V from PhoneArena. Right now I'm doing a quick review of the Lenovo Yoga Tablet 2 Pro. Now this is a pretty different Android tablet in the way that, first of all, it's a pretty massive tablet. It features a 13.3-inch display, quad HD display, and it's pretty nice, sharp detail. You get some nice viewing angles, pretty visible outdoors. It has a slightly saturated color reproduction due to its over 7,500 Kelvin color temperature, but still pretty attractive nevertheless. The second thing here that stands out is the built-in pico-projector that's incorporated into its cylindrical hinge. That's not something we tend to see in many tablets, so that's a nice offering to have. It's wonderful in the fact that we could project whatever we have on screen to a flat surface, so it really lends itself in watching videos and even, you know, having presentations. It's effective for that, but its brightness is not that strong, so you wanna, it's best used in lower lighting conditions. If there's ambient lighting that's around, it tends to diminish the quality, and its resolution stands at 854 by 480. So when you project it up to a 50-inch size, you know, it could look a little bit, you know, indistinct, but still it's just nice to have there. The one issue that we do have is just that when you're positioning the Pico projector and you're trying to interact with the tablet, you tend to move it around a lot. So we're constantly finding ourselves readjusting the focus. There's a slider right here to do that. And it's just kind of annoying just because you have to constantly do that just because the tablet is moving around. But design here still uses the same unorthodox design style of its siblings. You have that cylindrical hinge. It's just pretty massive in size, so it's not really ideal for a one-handed operation. You really need two hands for it. They have the kickstand. With this particular model, it's spring activated. You press the button right there, it pops out, and this time around, this year's model, it extends to a full 180 degrees. So if you want to, you can hang it, as Lenovo says, but it's not quite as practical compared to some of the other modes, like the stand mode for watching videos or tilt mode for actually typing up stuff with the on-screen keyboard. It's powered by a new chip from Intel. It's a quad-core Intel Atom chip. It's based on 64-bit architecture coupled with 2 gigabytes of RAM. And for the most part, you know, it's pretty responsive, but just doesn't have the same snappy feel that we get from other higher-end tablets. And it really gets tested when it comes to gaming. The experience here is it pretty much follows in suit to what we saw last year. It's a simplified Android 4.4.2 KitKat experience. There's no app panel, so the home screen can appear a little bit cluttered at times with all the icons. But the neat thing that we like is just the new multitasking element in play. So when you press the button in the bottom left corner at any time, we are given these various applications. When you select them, for example, the email app, the gallery, or Chrome, they're gonna open up in their own separate windows. So it gives us an enhanced multitasking experience. Now you can only have up to three, but still pretty nice to have there. It's also preloaded with the Kingsoft Office application. So with that, we're able to actually edit, you know, create Word documents. We could also create spreadsheet files and even presentations. So it kind of adheres to, you know, productivity-centric users who want to actually, you know, get some work down the road. So it's nice just because with the real estate, it's really spacious and it's perfect for that. It's also wonderful for other multimedia consumptive devices, I mean experiences. Like I said, watching videos, thanks to large display, the kickstand. It features JBL front-firing speakers with a subwoofer in the back, and with that, it just delivers a pretty robust audio experience, especially when you have the Dolby Audio surround sound enabled. It just gives it a more poppy tone to it. The camera in the back is an 8-megapixel camera. It produces average results. We wouldn't say there's anything outstanding with the quality. It's good for outdoor usage, so you'll get some decent looking details, though the focus tends to be a little bit on the slow side, so sometimes our photos just come out a little bit on the blurry side. Under lower lighting conditions, you get softer looking details, but it does a better job of adjusting its white balance than the Lenovo Yoga Tablet 2. It has just more realistic tone to it. Unfortunately though, you don't want to use this for shooting videos. 1080p video recording quality is just terrible. Abysmal in pretty much every facet. You know, it looks kind of pixelated. You have a very long and finicky focus adjustment, and top it off, the auto recording is just muffled and distorted. Battery life, you know, you kind of know that with such a large screen, you're gonna have a compromise with that. It has a 6900 milliamp hour battery, and I mean a 9600 milliamp hour battery, and with this, it achieves a mark of 6 hours and 43 minutes in our own battery benchmark test. That's nothing to really, you know, to be happy about, just because other tablets go over 9 hours. So, you know, that's kind of a concern if you kind of want to use this for a period of several days. In fact, in our normal everyday usage, we find at the most 1 day out of it. But overall, when you think about the $500 cost, you're getting a pretty sizable tablet, spacious screen, high resolution too, quad HD resolution, pretty generous with that, and you have the pico-projector. It's a fantastic multimedia consumptive device, and if you're willing to, you know, live with the Android experience that Lenovo has provided, it's not bad of an option. For $500, you can pick up an iPad Air 2 or a Samsung Galaxy Tab S 10.5, but you don't get the benefit of having that larger screen to play with or the Pico projector. So, you know, it's a toss-up. You could go with this or go with the other models. If you really like that Pico projector, or if you've been waiting for an Android tablet with a large display like this one, it's not bad of an option. So if you guys want to learn more about the Lenovo Yoga Tablet 2 Pro, you can check out our website, phonearena.com. It's John V. Thanks for watching.